Donald Trump does it on his own. He does it with his own persona. He backs up what he says. Now, if Melania Trump wants to do something against online bullying, really, all she's got to do is put a little melatonin in his nighttime milk and, you know, maybe lullaby him to sleep.
Or take his phone away, right?
Take his phone away, you know, tie his hands up, do something. But I get where she's coming from. But it's a very difficult argument to make when you are sleeping next to Donald Trump, who's tweeting at 3 a.m. in the morning and tweeting really ridiculous things at 3 a.m. in the morning.
So the interesting thing is, and I think that everyone, you know, if you did happen to split with Donald Trump, there was the one thing that said, okay, I just can't go past. For a lot of people, especially women, it was the Heidi Cruz thing when he retweeted the Heidi Cruz photo. So Sarah, this is for you. Isn't that the definition, though, of online bullying, and why isn't her husband held to the same standards that he, you know, that she wants to hold the kids to?
Look, I don't think that's her point at all. Melania certainly didn't say that her husband was perfect. What she did was come out and tell her story, tell what matters to her in terms of what she would take on as America's first lady. She has an incredibly powerful story, one that I thought was inspiring, and frankly, every show host and TV show tonight is talking about bullying, but in the wrong way. Instead of attacking Melania, why aren't we talking about the real epidemic here of cyberbullying? She's trying to bring and highlight an issue that is a problem, and I think we should, you know, give her credit for that.
I don't think we're attacking Melania. Certainly, yeah. I don't mean to attack Melania. I think she is a class act. I think she's a lovely woman.
She said herself,
she's come out,
you know,
to be much more grounded than her husband.
A lot of his tweets.
And I think she is. Is supportive and loving of her spouse.
Yeah.
That being said, her spouse is crazy and tweets crazy stuff in the middle of the night.
I would hardly say that her spouse is crazy. And I think when you say things like that and expect him not to respond is ridiculous. You're calling him a name while getting mad at him.
I am nothing but a talking head on TV. He is running for president.
Your father ran for president.
I was there for that, I remember.
And your father didn't respond to every surrogate, every news person, your father took the high road.
He was also very nice.
Right, and he's a nice man. I have to say that Donald Trump is a nice man, not a nice man, I'm not, but whatever. But your dad did not go about it, and most people don't go about it the way Donald Trump
did.
The most he is seen as a bully. Some of the things he said is a bully. I mean, look, come on, this is just Twitter. Come on, Sarah. Let's just be honest.
The most vicious things in this race, though, why are we talking about all the terrible things that Hillary Clinton has said?
But explain what that is. That's a two-page spread of people, places, and things that Donald Trump has attacked on Twitter. And you and me are on that list.
And Hillary Clinton calls millions of Americans deplorable and irredeemable, yet that's not a big deal. Let's just push that aside.
No, we talked about that. That's one thing. She said that one time in a speech. These are hundreds. Do you understand the difference?
I do, but I think you're missing the point of what Melania was trying to do today. She wanted to come out. She wanted to tell her story. If anybody at this point in the campaign is going low, it's Hillary Clinton.
She also apologized for that, too, as well.
Her campaign has turned to nothing but vicious personal attacks. These final days, that's all she's doing. She said she was going to take the high road. That's the opposite of what she has done in this.
You're absolutely right, and we discussed that the two segments
before that. While Donald Trump is...